Let's talk about this Relapse album. I'm very excited, you know.
So am I. I'm very excited. I'm extremely excited.
And I see you guys are going full-fledged right now with all the publicity. I saw the XXL Punisher cover. You look like you're in excellent shape. What have you been doing?
Oh, the beach is that way. I just been running a lot, you know, taking care of myself and, you know.
Lifting weights and stuff?
A little bit.
Mostly cardio.
Yeah, a lot of cardio. I'm at the point where I think I've been a little obsessive, compulsive about, like, running on a treadmill. Yeah, I got up to 4 miles a day, then I got up to 6, and then I got up to 10, then I got up to 15, then I got up to 17, and I had to, like, take a break.
How'd you skip 8 miles, you know? I had to. I'm sorry. So how much weight did you lose? Because you're very thin.
I don't know exactly how much weight I lost, but I lost quite a bit.
You had to buy new clothes and everything?
Yep, cleaned out my closet and... Hey,
that was clever.
Got a whole new wardrobe.
Let's talk about also the Vibe magazine cover and the number one stand contest, because we were discussing that up here. And the fact that the fans voted you the best rapper alive, that puts a lot of pressure on you, I'm sure. You know, does it? Like, do you get nervous about that?
I don't get nervous about it. I'm grateful for it. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? But as far as like pressure, I just wanna do what I do. You know.
Now, the first song, We Made You. Okay, I think it's amazing that you put that out. The video came out, but for some reason, the song didn't leak before the video came out. It seems like everybody has problems, you know, like Dr. Dre with the Detox album, with songs leaking before. You know, they're ready. How do you manage to do that? Like, what's the security measures in the studio?
Well, we either run a really tight ship or nobody just cares.
I think people care.
Nobody gives a shit.
No, I mean...
Maybe that's what happened. No, I don't know. We're just extremely careful with our shit. You know what I mean? Like, we don't... Like, I keep a CD with me, but, I mean, I'm the only one that usually has a CD. Like, me or Dre, but... You know, a lot of times, like, I mean, I'm usually the only one that has a CD. I think Dre has a, you know, like, Dre will take a CD and put it in his computer or something. I don't know what exactly he does with it. But, I mean, other than that, no one else has it.
Yeah, don't
no
leave your CDs with Dre anymore.
No copies to the label, Angie. No copies to the label. That's how we prevent it.
Ah, so that's where it's the breakdown at the label. Good to know.
Paul is
the label, so make sure he doesn't get a copy, right? So let me tell you something. I went on the Twitter and I told everybody I would be talking to you, so I do have questions from the people as well. You ready for these?
No doubt, son. Know what I mean?
Now, I was reading about how you said that you were inspired by Lil Wayne and T.I. and their albums. Would you work with Lil Wayne because he very badly wants to work with you?
I would. I mean, there hasn't really necessarily been a time for me to, like, really get out there and do collaborations and shit lately, because I've been so locked down in the studio. But I'm open for whatever. You know, there's a lot of artists in the game that I respect, you know, especially right now. Because, you know, I think I might have mentioned in one of the articles that I did lately that just for a while it seemed like hip-hop was... not really in a good place for, like, the, you know, like, a good 3 or 4 years. It just seemed to be, like, you know, it seemed like all anybody really cared about was making having a dope beat and making a good hook, and it was kind of no substance. And then it, you know, it seems to be coming back with artists like, you know, what I've said of lately, with artists like Lil Wayne, artists like T.I., you know, Kanye. I like Kanye a lot, too. You know, there's, I mean, it just seems like it's getting back to being in a good place again.
Fantastic, is it grand?
We're looking at all the massive
masses in the stands. Say they not know, don't massacre the fans.
Damn, I think Kim Kardashian is a man.
She's something just because he asked to put it. sweet and switch it and pass it to a pen.
Can it come back as nasty
as he can?
Yes, he can.
Don't ask me this again.
He does not mean a
lesbian in a pen.
But Lindsay, please come back to see him in.
Samantha's a tool, you're practically in sin.
I know you want me, girl. In fact, I see a grin.
Now come in, girl.
Welcome to the cutest girl in Charlie Horsa. Sorry, Porsche, but what's Ellen DeGeneres have that I don't?
Are you telling me?
Feminist? Well, I can be as gentle and as smooth as a gentleman. Give me my pen and an inhaler and tubes in a drip. And I'll invite Sarah Palin up to dinner then. Nail her. Baby, say hello to my little friend. Brick picket cane feathers cut off the middleman. Forget him or you're gonna end up in the hospital again. And this time it won't be for the bitterness
binge.
Forget the mother man, girl, pay the
middle attention.
Little did I mention that Jennifer's in. Love with me, John Mayer, so sit on the bench. Man, I swear them other guys,
you give them an inch.
They take a mile, they got style, but it isn't slim.
Make my jail break.
Baby, I figured this mansion's home, and I'll
bring it down, girl.